Okay. All right, Reverend Moore.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
If I can, before you jump in.
Yes.
Just remind you, I know you're aware of this protocol, but we have 11 minutes before we have to take up by advertisement our public hearing. So just want to beg your forgiveness on the front end. If we run through on your issue, we'll have to interrupt you and then come back.
I understand. I'm approaching City Council. We received a grant through the City of Washington, Community Development Block Grant. I think it was back in 2005 that grant was funded. It was about a 3-year delay on when we could actually get the land because the long lot was being looked at. And when we finally got around to getting everything ready to go, it was 2008. The difficulty that I'm having now is that same CDBG grant, we've had some problems with the financing. The contract said that we would build 5 houses for low to moderate income families. And the land was purchased, infrastructure was put in, and I'm here today asking City Council if you would consider paying the water and sewer tap fees for those 5 structures. Now, what's happened is, back in the day when we used to do this, before the economy tanked, Metropolitan would go in and build 5 to 10 houses at a time. We would get a construction loan from the bank, we'd build the houses, and then we'd sell them. After the economy eroded, banks stopped lending, especially the nonprofits. So now what we've got to do is try to build them a structure at a time. And I'd have to build one, then sell it, then build another one, then sell it until I can get to the 5. Well, the problem is that Commerce has put a window on us that we need to quickly get it done. So what I'm trying to do now, or the city has to pay back the funding. We've never had that happen before, and I don't foresee that happening this time. But I am in the position to start construction, and I need the city's help on this. And the reason why I'm coming is, number one, Metropolitan's track record. We have never, this is our 6th CDBG grant from the City of Washington. Never have we been derelict in duty. Number two, our track record is spotless. If I say I'm gonna build them for low to moderate income, I'm gonna do that. Number three, I gotta start and get it done quickly because I don't want this to fall back on the City of Washington for you to have to take over something that I'm responsible for. So in a nutshell, what I need is the water and sewer taps so that we can quickly get into construction. Then I'd be able to finish the 5 houses and come back to you with phase 2. Phase 2 is where we pave the road, finish out the last of the 5 houses, and put an end to the 10 house subdivision.
Questions for Reverend Moore?
Mr. Mayor, first of all, let me say I have applauded Reverend Moore and Metropolitan any number of times from this podium for the work that he has done in the past and removing substandard housing from a wide area in the city. And he is to be commended for those activities. And I'll sit here and commend him from now on for those activities. However, this grant has been a snafu from day one. First of all, and Holland's representative is not here, Holland messed up. And Reverend Moore and Councilman Moultrie came to my house in 2008, and we had a long discussion regarding this project at that time. Reverend Moore and others went to Raleigh and acquired an extension to the grant at that point in time and a modification to the grant to reduce it from 13 building sites back to five building sites. We acquired the properties, we put in the infrastructure, and in order to put in the infrastructure as it was required, we had to put in an additional $50,000 to $60,000 above what was outlined in the grant. We did that. Then about 6 months or so ago, Reverend Moore and Metropolitan approached us that he really needed some assistance in clearing the lands so that he could proceed with construction. We put another $10,000 to $12,000 into clearing that property. Now Reverend Moore is asking us to forgive some $11,000 worth of water and sewer taps and building fees, and the indication is that we will recoup that money in a 3 to 4 year period of time. And that's true if he builds the houses in the next 3 or 4 years. At this point in time, I'm not asked, and I don't know whether he has contracts for one or more of the houses that he proposes to build. The difficulty that I have at this point in time, and I wish Mr. Fitzell was here because he could answer the questions, and certainly Mr. Moore can answer the John Rodman can answer the questions along with Reverend Moore. When this grant was issued in 05 and extended in 08, the termination of the ending date, as I understand it, was April of 2012. Sometime in the latter part of last year, the Department of Community Assistance notified us that that project had been defunded, and we were responsible for the repayment of a $250,000 grant. City Manager Kay went to Raleigh and negotiated a repayment plan for the city at the rate of $25,000 a year for the next 10 years, and I believe that we budgeted that $25,000 payment, the first one in the 2013-14 budget. So we've actually budgeted money to begin to repay the callback on this grant, which has at that time been defunded. I don't know, unless someone can present me written correspondence that says that there's something that's different than that. I think at this point in time, the city has got $250,000 invested in the project, in addition to the other monies that we have put into this project. And I just cannot pour more money into this project.
Mr. Mayor, I appreciate Mr. Mercer's opinion. I think he's wrong, and that's my personal opinion. No one has built more houses for single-family folk than I have. Every time we build a house, the city collects revenue from the taxes, the city collects revenue from the utilities, the city collects revenue from the sewer, the city collects revenue from the stormwater. We have built over 88 houses in the city of Washington, and nobody can ever say anything negative about our track record. I told you I'm going to build these five houses. I'm going to build them. I'm a man of my word. I've been here almost 30 years. I ain't going nowhere. And I'm asking the city to give me the $11,000 so that I can go ahead and get going. Now,
well, no, and I think your points are solid, and certainly the partnership between the city and Metropolitan has been a good one. I think maybe, John, you could add some enlightenment here. There are a couple of points of clarification. One is it the 11th hour, or is it already struck midnight? We seem to think up here that the buzzer has sounded. It sounds to me like Reverend Moore thinks we've still got some time to pull this thing out of the fire.
And you're, Ms. Mercer, correct, and you're correct, it is the 12th hour, and that's why we're having a public hearing, is to close out this '05 grant. But let me tell you what my understanding was. Now, it's nothing written that Mr. Mercer was asking for, but it was my understanding, and I spoke with Reed Weitzel from Holland, and it was also his understanding, that even though the grant is closed out, if Reverend Moore builds these houses, then those repayments that the city has to make, or whoever's making, will be reduced by each house that he builds, and if he builds all the houses, that repayment could possibly be forgiven. Now, that's my understanding. It's not written anywhere, and I have no proof of that.
Now, that would be a huge, huge point to get clarification on. So I would think we need to see that in writing.
Yeah, there's nothing in writing, but that was my understanding.
Okay, well, let's see. I don't know who we need to talk to get that clarification, but let's get that. And then I also need to, for the council's benefit and for Reverend Moore, the letter we had to go back and check some of the figures here. And just for the council's information, the number per house with tap fees and permits is actually $3,220 per house. So the total is $16,100 by my calculation of the five houses, all permits, all tap fees, rather than $11,025. So
okay.
Just for clarification.
And I appreciate that. Only thing I can say, Mr. Mayor, is our partnership has always worked. It will still work. I have run into some economic downfall, but I'm here, haven't gone anywhere. And if I tell you I'm going to build them, I'm going to build them. If I've done 88, I think it's pretty understanding that I can do five.
Okay. All right, if we could just pause right there. I'm getting a cue from the wings that it's 6 o'clock, and we've got these two public hearings, one of which is a Keys Landing public hearing, but the first is the annexation ordinance to extend the city of Washington corporate city limits for a contiguous annexation. That's WIMCO, located at 1724 1730 Carolina Avenue. Our second public hearing is the closeout fiscal year 05 CDBG housing development program. This is the Keys Landing grant. Now in public hearing.
Yes, sir, Mr. Mayor, thank you. This is the public hearing for the 05 Keys Landing CDBG grant. We have the original deadline has passed without the City of Washington or Metropolitan achieving any of their national objectives. Community assistance has recommended that this grant be closed out and the money returned.
Okay. John.
Yes, sir.
Is this closeout a formality in light of the fact that we have already been asked to, and that the project has been defunded and we have been asked to refund the money?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So it's strictly a formality, whether we do it or not, the project has been closed.
Well, this is a formality that has to be done in order to close out that. That's correct.
Right. Yes. In other words, we have to hold a public hearing before we can close it out.
That's correct.
Right?
Right.
And so what we're doing now is satisfying that requirement by holding the public hearing, but we don't necessarily have to take action immediately following, right? And here's what I'm getting at. I want to make sure we don't misstep before getting the clarification that we were talking about for Reverend Moore by closing out, if in fact there's some technicality that by leaving it open we don't want to preclude ourselves from any kind of mitigation.
And I'm not sure I'm looking at the Mr. Holscher to see if he can add anything to that.
We're all looking at you, Mr. Holscher.
Well, all I know is the materials are presented here, no action is requested. And this was, I believe, prepared by your grant administrator.
That's correct.
that would be the one that I would want to ask that question to. It's my understanding that you hold this public hearing to fulfill one of the grant requirements, and you've got a checklist, and it gets checked off, and...
And there is no action taken. If I recall, last month when we closed out the talent enhancement grant, we held a public hearing, but there was no action taken.
Right, and that's what I want to make sure. If we've got one scintilla of an opportunity to mitigate our commitment back to the state, I want to make sure we don't get out in front of ourselves and maneuver ourselves out of that opportunity.
I understand.
And I concur wholeheartedly. If there's an opportunity within the next 3 weeks or 4 weeks to have an exchange of written documents that says and spells out conditions that we can look at and read and approve what's written, but it's very difficult to say, it's my understanding, because my understanding and William's understanding and Richard's understanding, we can all hear the same thing and have three different understandings. And so I personally, problem with delaying any further action, but whatever we do, we need to get clarified in very distinct language so that we can all understand.
Right. Can we do that?
Yes, sir.
So okay. Instead of, you're still in the public hearing, right?
Yeah, this is part of the public hearing.
Perhaps you would not close the public hearing and you would continue to your next regular meeting.
I can do that.
Mr. Mayor.
Yes, sir.
Can I speak during the public
hearing? Hold on one second. Any more questions for John? Hearing none, I'll call for the public. Trevor Moore, you can go for it.
I think you definitely don't want to close it out.
Right. Okay. Good. Okay. Any other questions for John? Any other comments from the public, either in favor or in opposition to this? Yes, sir.
Mr. Mayor, Councilman, my name is Casey Cox. My address is 221 Alderson Road in Smallwood. My house is directly adjacent or behind the Keys Landing project. I think that I agree with the closing out of the grant, and I think that you're just like asking for another extension. If this was taking place or the grant was approved in 2005 and the builder and contractor had to go to, or landowner had to go to the state to get an extension in 2008, and the deadline was April of last year, it just seems like we're just continuing this again. So I have a number of reasons why I disagree with the project, but I'll just let it stand at that.
Okay, thank you. Any other comments from the public? Okay. Hearing none, we can move forward, continuing the public hearing until our next scheduled meeting. Is that what we want to do?
I think we can.
Procedurally?
Yeah.
Everybody okay with that? Okay, let's do it by motion.
I
made it seconded. Okay.
Public hearing on our next meeting.
Okay. Second?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
And all those opposed? Okay. Now, if we would, do we want to revisit our issue on the tap fees, or we'll leave that till the next meeting as well?
I'd rather revisit it and take care of that tonight. Take a vote on that.
All right. We'll continue that. Concurrently. All right. Anyone else has signed up that would like to speak from the public on any other issue?
Yes, sir.
Okay. We'll move forward then.